Start with Pinpoint Weather on a scorching day all across the metro area with record-setting heat.
It is now the hottest day of the year so far. Right now, temperatures nearing the century mark. And if Denver hits 100 degrees, it will be our first 100-degree day since August 5th of last year. That was 381 days ago. Let's get right to Chief Meteorologist Dave Fraser with a closer look at some of that record-breaking heat we're seeing today, Dave.
Yeah, we actually did two records. The first one came this morning when the low temperature at the airport did not get below 72 degrees. That is the new warm record low this morning, beating the old record from 1946 of 67 degrees. Now, when you start at 72, it doesn't take much sunshine to get you into the upper 90s. And we did that when we hit 99 this afternoon. It does not appear we got to 100. 97 was the old record from 2007. So that's two record lows on this hot day. Now, because of the hot temperatures from Denver up the I-76 corridor, there is a heat advisory. This is for sensitive groups, really. Only that are sensitive to the hot temperatures. It's only going to last for a couple more hours because the hottest part of the day is behind us. Matter of fact, we're now down to 97, so away from the high. Triple-digit heat down to the south and east and 80s and 90s out west. Denver, Fort Collins, Greeley, eastern Colorado, a little warmer than we were this time on Sunday, while out west it's a little cooler. So there's your temperatures down into the 80s and then continuing to 80 at 11 o'clock tonight. Now, Erica just said to me a few minutes ago she didn't think it felt that hot outside. It's because it's breezy. When you have a nice breeze stirring, it kind of helps to cut the heat. However, that wind out of the south has prompted until 7 o'clock tonight, a red flag warning for high fire danger.